The construction sector is one of the largest producers of human-driven CO2 emissions in the world. These emissions come from energy consumption and from leftovers generated by manufacturing processes.
With the concrete project based here in Belgium, we are producing tomorrow's building blocks with a revolutionary twist, a cement-free building material that literally eats CO2. We do this by using the power of two byproducts, the CO2 coming from the production of lime and the slag coming from the production of stainless steel, and we turn them into environmentally friendly materials.
Lime plays a crucial role in steel manufacturing and is used in many other useful processes. But every kilo of lime produced creates around 750 grams of CO2, which would normally just be released into the atmosphere.
Slag created during steel production. In our process, we bring the CO2 containing fumes to our facilities along a 2 km pipe and use them to harden our masonry blocks. During this hardening process, CO2 reacts with slag and is converted forever into carbonates, just as in natural stone.
We estimate that using the CO2 in this way will avoid the emissions of more than 190,000 tons of CO2 over the first 10 years of operation. This is equal to nearly 2,000 European average homes over the same period.
The decarbonization of aviation and maritime sector is of great challenge, not only for Europe, but for the world in general. The BioSFera project explores a new way to produce fuels for ships and planes using renewable sources such as olive tree prunings, sawdust and forest residues. We use various technologies and tools from different scientific fields to make this process efficient and sustainable, such as biological, thermal and catalytic technologies. The technology will bring more efficient ways for industries and farmers to turn biogenic residues and renewable waste into valuable fuels. The contribution of this project is to increase the production of renewable fuels, getting closer to the goal of making the transportation sector 100% green by 2050.